Hello everyone, my name is Rajita Mathur, currently working as a legal intern at LexClick. So today I will be discussing on a topic, rule of harmonious construction. Harmonious construction refers to such construction by which harmony or oneness amongst various provisions of an enactment is arrived at. In other words, whether the word of statutory provision has more than one meaning and there is a doubt as to the meaning should prevail, that such meaning should be adopted with the best harmonized with the subject of the enactment. Now, it is presumed that legislature has enacted a law with a definite purpose. It also presumed that legislature has used a precise word to open the mind and have left no ambiguity in the leg of enactment. Further, it is presumed that the provision of statute are well composed and consistent with each other. Further, as legislature is not supposed to contradict itself by providing conflicting provisions, hence statute should be constructed in such a manner to avoid any repugnancy. The main intention of the legislature is that every provision should remain operative. Further, there was a case, the name of the case is CIT versus Hindustan Bulk Carrier. The Supreme Court in this case laid down 5 principles of rule of harmonious construction. First, the court must avoid the issue which are contradictory. Second, the provision of one section can't be used to defeat the provisions of other section unless the court is unable to find a way to reconcile their differences. Third rule can be, in such a case where it is impossible to reconcile the differences, then the court must interpret them in such a way that both the provisions should have the same effect. Further, the court must keep in mind that the interpretation reduces one provision to useless number or deed is not a harmonious construction. To harmonize doesn't mean to destroy any statutory provisions or to render it fruitless. Further, there was a case, Re Kerala Education Bill 1951. In this case, it was being decided that the fundamental rights, the court must consider the directive principles and adopt the principles of harmonious construction so that the two possibilities are being given an effect as much as the possible by striking a balance. Further, there was another case and the name of the case is Bhatia International versus Bulk Trading. In this case, it was held that if more than one interpretation is possible for a statute, then the court has to choose the interpretation which shows the intention of the legislature. Now, this rule of harmonious construction is basically based upon the two maxims. First is generalia celibus non derogant. The general rule to be followed in case of a conflict in between two states is that the latter abrogates the earlier one. Special law would yield to later general law if either the following two conditions is being satisfied. The two are inconsistent with each other. If either of these two conditions is fulfilled, the latter can, even though general would prevail. Now, in another case, Union of India versus Dilip Kumar Singh. In this case, Supreme Court held that the provision of statute must be read harmoniously together whether it is not possible and there is conflict between the two sections, then it must be determined which provision is leading provision and which is subordinate provision and that which one must give away to the another. Now, in the second maxim which talks about generalia specialia derogant. This maxim states that the special things derogate from general things. In other words, the general provision has no application in the matter that are being governed by the special provision. It excludes the application of general provision and always override the general provision. But this overriding effect is restricted to the extent of inconsistency between them. Thank you.